Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. Today it's actually the 16th of August, and it's my birthday, so if you want to congratulate me, like the video, share it with your friends, and whatnot. But enough about me. In today's video, we're going to have a look at how to do stuff like this. And of course, we do need to import our 3D object, and how are we actually going to do that inside of DaVinci Resolve? That is what this video is going to be all about. If you are new to this channel and want to learn DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks and want to have a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. And if you want to support the channel even more, hit that join button down below and become a member of this channel. Also, you can join our Facebook group and let's build a community over there. All right, with that out of the way, let's get to the tutorial. Okay, so let's get started with the tutorial. So first off, to import a 3D object, we first off would need to put in a fusion composition, and you can find those under the effects library effects. And here in the top fusion composition, I'm just going to drag that down in my timeline, and then I'm just going to pop into fusion. So here in fusion, all we have is a media out node. So the way we would import a 3D object into fusion is, there's different formats. There's the OBJ format and other formats. I'm going to use the OBJ format, and I did find a 3D model on the internet. And if you find a 3D model and it's not in the right format, you can get a program like Blender and just open it up in Blender and then export it as a OBJ file. So first off, let's go up here to the Fusion tab up here, and we're going to import a FBX scene. Going to click here, and it's going to open up my window, and here I have my Blender or my OBJ project, so I'm just going to open that. Now we're going to have a menu up here, and depending on the 3D model, the things out here might be different. It can be less or more, but nevertheless, this looks just fine, so we're just going to push OK. And here we have the 3D model, and we can actually take the 3D transform here and just put that up here so we can see what we have here. And if we push down control and middle mouse, we can actually scroll, so we can actually see how big this also is. Cool. So let's get this inside of Fusion, and you could put a background or whatever. I'm going to put in a background. I'm going to connect that to the media out. And now I need to connect my transform 3D down here. And I'll do that with a 3D renderer. So we're going to put that, the transform, into the renderer. And the transform is just making us able to move our 3D object around. Then again, now we have a renderer, and I need to connect my renderer down to my 2D. So how do we connect our renderer 3D to our 2D composition down here? We can simply add in a merge, or we can drag down the renderer to the background node and let go, and we have a merge. And now we have our thing here. But of course, for our background, which is a 1080 background, this is a very big model. So if we go into the transform, we can actually go into the scale here, and then we can scale this down quite a bit like that. And here we have our lovely, lovely, lovely Star Wars TIE Fighter. And also we'll need to add in a little bit more. I think we should add in a, this is a merge 3D. We need to add in a light, and then in this case, I just want to add in some, I'll push the control spacebar, and I'm just going to type in light. Just going to put in a directional light, I think. I'm going to add that in. And here I have my light. Of course, before we can start to play around with the lights, we do need to go into the renderer, and we're going to enable light and shadows. Okay. So I'm going to go into the transform of the light, and we can play around with the different things. But of course, we're going to play around with the rotation. So we can actually see if I go over to our TIE Fighter here, I'm going to zoom in a bit and we can actually see if we play around with the rotations, we can play around with the lights, and it's going to make this 3D model look way cooler. So, and then if I go to my media out here, I have this image here. I'm going to zoom out a bit. So if we want to do some kind of a quick movement, we could just add in a 3D camera and put that before our transform. And we'll go into the 3D camera, go into the transform, and we're going to, we can also drag this back. So here we actually have a, so if we wanted to do like a super quick animation, we could actually just go into our camera. I'm going to put in a rotation on the C, and then I'll just go a couple of frames forward, like 50 frames or whatever. And I'm going to zoom this towards the camera, something like that, so it'll pass by. So super quickly, we made this little effect. Put in some sound effects, and we are now having a flying TIE Fighter in our scene. So this is the basic of how to import 3D models into Fusion inside of DaVinci Resolve 17. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.